The President, please be seated.
Le Président, veuillez vous
asseoir. The court is now in session.
L'audience est reprise.
In the moment, we are going to hear the
d'ici quelques instants,
remarks
nous allons
from
entendre
the defense counsel and the accused, who will be
par le Conseil de la Défense et par
presenting their closing statements.
Ils vont en effet
the chamber would like to remind the accused and his counsel that you will have 7 hours and a half altogether for the counsel and the accused. And the chamber would like to be informed from the defense counsel whether the counsel would wish to make the closing statement first or would it wish to give the floor to the accused to make such remarks. Mr. President, may it please the court, the accused is allowed to make his final remarks first.
Qui va faire ses observations d'abord.
The President, the accused, you may now proceed with your closing remarks. If you can do that while you are still on your feet,
it would be good. Faire, debout, si vous le souhaitez.
The accused, Mr. President, and your honors,
Monsieur le Président,
I am very grateful to you for giving me this opportunity to make my final remarks. To begin with, I would like to read the statement I prepared, which is about the continuous killing by the Communist Party of Cambodia, CPK. The objective
qui ont été commis par le Parti
is
communiste du Cambodia.
Ascertain the general aspect from which a particular aspect can be derived in accordance with the general and particular principle,
général,
both being mutual contributors.
Peut,
the general aspect in this case refers to the killing
dans
carried out
affaire,
by the CPK during its entire history, whereas the particular aspect refers to the crimes committed from the 17th of April 1975 to the 6th of January 1979 at S21 in particular. Killings before the 17th of April 1975. 1. The CPK began to kill people as soon as it began to carve out a liberated sector. 2. The misleading slogan used to conceal the CPK's crimes was to destroy infiltrator in order to protect the revolutionary force.
3.
The most publicized song at the supporting base was entitled The Malicious Infiltrator. People who entered from the Lonel sector For during that time, people in the territory occupied by Lonor forces who entered the liberated sector would definitely be arrested and sent to the police office.
5.
The police office had to be ready to receive the arrested people so as to have them detained, interrogated, and smashed. Smashing the enemy was the policy adopted by the party. The president, the accused, could you please hold on? You now may be seated while reading your document. But number two, could you please be reminded that you have been rather fast? And for the good record, could you please repeat point number 5 so that the interpreters could well catch up with what you are saying?
5 pour que les interprètes puissent eux-mêmes se reprendre.
Continues. People in the liberated sector.
7.
Having read and analyzed the text in the Revolutionary Flag magazine, the second semester issue of the 1971, particularly the text on the experience acquired in the suppression of the Kut Udambung Ratana armed rebellion, I am convinced that there were arrests and executions of people in the liberated sector as from the beginning. The sector armed force was deployed to oppose those who engaged in armed rebellion against them. Suspects were arrested and sent to the police office.
3.
The people in the supporting base.
8.
Amleng commune in Tpong district, Kampong Spu province, was the supporting base. Widespread and systematic arrests of the children of Amleng villages were carried out after the B-52 bombs had been dropped on Krang Kau village, which was the zone of its location. There were human casualties. Next, I would like to report on the actual situation. A day after the bombardment, Ong Chun, alias Mok, ordered the arrest of 3 Chinese who he suspected and had them sent to M13. Mok ordered Chu Jade, alias C, to observe this interrogation closely in order to ensure that the problem was solved in good time. When suspicions and arrests proliferated, 2 people arrived separately in Amleng in order to live there. Other people, the children of Amleng villagers, each sought refuge in sight in turn. A while later, they left. The 4 of them were arrested by the zone and sent to M13. 3 confessed that they were asked to infiltrate the area. The 4th person, who was a middle-aged man with a full-grown daughter, had abducted his best friend's wife to Udong. He confessed that Colonel Hong Yu and Lieutenant Colonel Sari Sai had discharged approximately 200 rifles and had them brought into the liberated sector already.
Mock
and C were convinced that the confession were true because both of them fully grasped this person's personal biography. It was a fortunate coincidence that Mock was indeed in need of weapons to build up military forces
to fight Phnom Penh.
Mock ordered me to find the weapons mentioned in the confession. To the best of my collection, hereforth, he required me to report regularly to him on the matter.
She
helped determine the objective thought in interrogating some individuals as well as the methods of torture to be used. I worked very hard for about 6 months searching for the weapons, but none was found. During that time, about 50 armed villagers died in terrible conditions. The cause of death was a combination of the fact that they were under suspicion and had been implicated by other people's confessions. As a result, the inhabitants of Biem village lost more lives than those of surrounding villages. Biem villages was a former public gathering place of the Pong district during the Sihanouk and Lonor regimes. 10. She called those who perished the feudalists and capitalists. This characterization is intended to convey contempt. A medium-level cadre, the son of a villager who was part of the supporting base, but had been blamed or had blamed the villagers for a change of heart. He said that in 1971 we had been jet mui or one of heart. However, in 1972 our heart broke into two, that is, jet bi or two hearts. I was completely terrified at this destruction, but I just did not know what I could do about it. The only opinion available to me was to devise a proper interrogation tactic. I brought Comrade Pond to interrogate an old bachelor who came once worked as a newspaper reporter. As his interrogation progressed, we learned on the job. It took us more than a month to complete that interrogation.
13.
My commitment and the skill Pon and I developed had plunged us both deep into a criminal act. We were made to work endlessly. The work were assigned, or we were assigned, was criminal. Internal purge. Party cadres were arrested even before the 17th of April 1975. 14. I still remember two parties' lines concerning the internal purge. First, the 10 criteria for selecting a cadre were based on a principle characterized by the organizational policy to demote and promote party members and cadres at the behest of the party. The seniority of the party member no longer satisfied the criteria set forth in the party statute of 1960. A second line was the theoretical principle on those on whose basis the party could carry out purges. Their theory was, whose class the line belongs, the cadre shall be from within that class. The notion was propounded in the Revolutionary Flag magazine in 1973. Note, the party statutes of 1960 and 1971 and the Revolutionary Flag magazine of 1973 were never published. However, the 10 criteria appeared in Article 5, Chapter 2 of the Party Statute of 1976. 15. Anyone the party identified as an enemy had to be smashed. The chief of police office had no right to challenge such a decision. Now I would like to recall the events of 1973. That year, a platoon secretary accused his deputy secretary of attempting to shoot while he was asleep. Luckily, the bullet pierced his mosquito net and hammock. Mock had great trust in that person who was reporting the incident. He gave me firm orders to be hard on him. Meanwhile, Mock let me meet the complainant to obtain more information from him and to examine the exhibits, the mosquito net and the hammock. I analyzed them and observed him, including his facial expression. I reported my finding to Mock through one way, as I did not wish to upset him. According to the finding, it was the comrade secretary of the platoon himself who had fired the bullet. As a result, no one there released the defendant. I learned through one way that Mock told Pol Pot he found it difficult to employ me. In 1976, Sun Sen advised me that politics govern technique. 16. I now turn to the event of the internal purge in the former Southwest Zone, which, according to my recollection, occurred as follows. As from 1968, Mock started to destroy the intellectual and petty bourgeois cadres. Within 24 hours, he expelled four cadres from the Southwest Zone. They were all former primary and high school teachers. In July 1971, Mock had basically accomplished his plan to destroy people. The special zone created in July 1971 was the place where people gathered. The elements expelled by Mock were seen working in the surrounding office of the zone. In the former Southwest zone, no intellectual or petty bourgeois cadre could be appointed chief of a sub-district or military unit. Between 1971 and 17th of April 1975, Mock ordered the smashing of some important cadres. 17. At that time, I was not yet critical thinker. The only thing that stuck in my mind was that I was afraid of being removed. The movement sought people was the common phrase used at the time. In other words, the movement renounced people. Even now, I am still convinced that I owe my survival in part to the fact that I have followed Von Wade's advice, which is, do not make any decision to arrest people. Do not touch the spoils of war. Do not get into moral misconduct with women. 18. I am not going to describe the event of the internal purge within other zones as I have no supporting documents. 19. Before the 17th of April 1975, the characteristics of the killing were, firstly, collective. People were killed regardless whether they were from Lonel's territory, were living in the newly liberated sector, were of the supporting base, or combatants, party members, or cadres. Secondly, non-scientific people were killed because they were suspected by the leaders of the zone or because they were implicated by confessions extracted at the police office. It can be said that they ordered the killing of the people for the short and long-term economic and political gains of their groups. The implementation line of the police office. The chief of the police office had no right to make arrests. The party made such decisions. Note, the term party is, in this context, refers to the secretary and undersecretary of the zone, or deputy secretary of the zone. 21. Physical torture was a method they made us use. Most often, it was inevitable. Note, I received instructions from Chai Kum Ho, 4, regarding the torture at M13.
La plupart du
later
temps,
on,
inévitable.
I received the instructions from one way.
22,
the police or the policy to smash those who were called infiltrators or the traitors of the revolution was adopted by the party. In practical terms, when someone was arrested and sent by the party to the police, the police had to interrogate him or her and then smash the person. As regards my leadership and working behavior, I knew how to control and manage myself. I did not want to be criticized by a Khmer proverb which goes, they offer you a chance to take the lead, but you do not know how to swing your arms while walking. They ask you to walk behind the others, but you do not know how to carry things. Killing after the 17th of April 1975. For the period from the 17th April 1975 until the 30th of March 1976. The evacuation of the population and the expulsion of the foreigners from Cambodia was a CPK plan, which was known as the plan to prepare for victory. The study session conducted from 24th of June 1975 to the 27th of June 1975 reflects its essence. It can be found in document 2 entitled The Vision on the Current Situation of Our Revolution and Some of Our Measures. 35. During the exodus, military force was used. The military was ordered to use violence as well as barbaric rhetoric to terrify and expel people, first by making them leave their homes, then the cities, and finally they were taken to the countryside. During the mass evacuation, the military was ordered to arrest high-ranking soldiers, police, civil servants, and senior religious leaders so that they could be smashed secretly. The names and personal biographies of the people who reached the countryside were registered by the base cadres, who were appointed by the zone en quart. This was done to screen for elements to be smashed. In the southwest zone, which was to the north of the National Road Number 4, C, the Deputy Secretary of the Zone, was the one who bore the greatest responsibility of this killing. All across Cambodia, those who were enjoyed full power and were most responsible for crimes during the first period were Pol Pot, first Party Secretary, Nguyen Chia, Deputy Secretary, Sao Pum, Secretary of the East Zone, Mok, Secretary of Southwest Zone, former and new, Won Wei, Secretary of the Special Zone, Son Sen, Deputy Secretary of the Special Zone, Khoi Thuon, Secretary of the North Zone, Gai Bok, Deputy Secretary of the North Zone, Si, Deputy Secretary of former Southwest Zone and Secretary of the West Zone, Nhum, Secretary of the Northwest Zone. Note, before and after the 17th of April 1975, all divisions of the army belonged to the zone. And from the 17th of April, all Cambodia territory except Phnom Penh belonged to the zone. The forces, including party members, the Youth League, and progressive people belonged to the zone. The old people were also under the zone. Therefore, the millions of evacuated people were managed by these 10 individuals. They decided who was to be killed and who was to be spared. I do not have any supporting documents in regard to the number of those who were killed during this first phase. However, I believe that the number could be as high as several thousand. In May 1975, Cheng On was ordered by the party to collect workers who were evacuated out of Phnom Penh to get back to the factories. Separate note, Since I had wished to escape the police work, I pleaded with Cheng An to make me work with him in the field of industry. Cheng An was pleased with my plea, but Sun Sen rejected. On an identified date, soon after the 17th of April, the special zone was dissolved. The territory within Sector 15, according to, including Ong Snul, Kandal Steng, Ponyer Lu, and Dong Cao, was placed under C's authority. The party renamed it the West Zone. The territory within Sector 25, Saang, Koh Thom, Leuk Daik, Kien Swai, was placed under Mok's authority. It renamed the New Southwest Zone. According to the information I obtained, the committee of Sector 25 was completely dissolved by the party. Partially or practically, the entire force under Khoi Thun plus himself were removed from the north to be scattered in the ministry. Khoi Thun himself was in the commerce section. The majority of the people in the section were from the north. Other ministries such as energy and water transportation were staffed by people from the north. Sue Wa Si, alias Duan, was ordered by the party to work at 870, and Jie Chan, alias Sreng, was left to work at the base as deputy secretary to Kaipok. The military personnel of the four zones which attacked Phnom Penh were recruited as the center military, which was under the direct supervision of Sun Sen. The offices and ministries surrounding 870 were put to use soon after the 17th of April. However, the committees of these offices and ministries were gradually modified until there was a meeting of the Standing Committee on 19, 20, and 21st of April 1976, when it was officially appointed. Meanwhile, alongside the organizational arrangement of the center military, offices and ministries surrounding 870, the commanders of soldiers and soldiers, chiefs of police, the chiefs of civil servants, were searched and arrested, some of whom were sent to S21. The blood of the Cambodian people, both in the rural areas and Phnom Penh, kept shedding endlessly. Document of the 30th of March 1976 was the document decided and determined when the CPK had appointed the zones for overseeing rural bases across the country, had appointed the offices and ministries for the functioning of state activities, had appointed the independent zone due to its unique geography, had appointed the center army to be under supervision of the chief of the general. Note, document of the 30th of March 1976 was known to me at the ECCC. Through this document, the power to make a decision to smash was given to four groups of people as follows: the Standing Committee of the Zone, the Committee of the Central Office. Standing Committee here refers to the Central Standing Committee, the general staff. There were 11 individuals who were nominated in the groups. One, Pol Pot, Nuon Chia, Sao Pem, Mok, Sun Sen, Kieu Sompon, Ya, Ruos Nhim, Kai Pok, C, and 11, Sai. The policy of power sharing was the strictest one. Apart from the 11 people, no one else had such right. For example, Khoi Thun, the full-fledged member of the center, but in his capacity as the minister, the right to decide to smash was not vested in him. Nat, former secretary of S21, received the tough measure from the party because he subjectively made a decision to arrest people. The second purpose of the first paragraph of the document about the right to smash states that it was in order to strengthen our democratic socialism. Democratic socialism or centralized democracy means that the collective rule which each individual is responsible individually. Collective is the entire party which was represented by the party secretary, who was Pol Pot. Individuals in the framework of the right to smash were each of the zone secretaries, the chief of the central office, and the chief of the general staff. This means that if an individual failed to respect the leadership of the collective, he or she had to be punished. For example, Kong Chab, alias Sai, secretary of the North Zone, had the right to smash people according to the party line. However, when Sai went to arrest the relatives of Kyo Sampan's wife, he was arrested on the order of Pol Pot and sent to S21. Kyo Sampan's wife's relatives were released on the order of Pol Pot. Note, see, the secretary of the West experienced the same problem. To put it simply, they never allowed a knife to cut its own handle. Soon after the 30th of March 1976, the internal purge of people in the party's rank held sway. The purge swept through all zones, starting from each zone. The purge was carried out across all ministries, each minister at a time. The purge was conducted in all divisions, one at a time. It can be said that the internal purge started from the April of 1976 and stemmed from two main events. First, a grenade attack behind the palace on the 2nd of April 1976. Second, Khoi Thun was placed under house arrest from the 8th of April 1976. Thanks to the confession of the person who was behind the grenade attack, Chan Chakrai was arrested on the 19th of May 1976. His arrest and Suos No's arrest were the stepping stone leading to the subsequent purge in the East Zone. People within Khoi Thun's network could have been arrested much earlier. The delay was due to the fact that they were waiting until Khoi Thun's confession was extracted. I would like to note that on the 25th of January 1977, Thun was sent to S21. On the 29th of January 1977, Thun wrote and completed his first confession. On the 31st of January 1977, people in Thun's network in Phnom Penh and the North Zone who were implicated by him in his confession were all arrested and sent to S21. The purge of Khoi Thun's network terrified me again for the second time. This time it was most shocking. I wonder why the North peasants had to die, why Mok's peasants were always on the right side and more prosperous. I had known many of the people who were sent here. Some used to be in jail in Preysaw with me, some used to pay visits to my parents' home. It was very distressing. I couldn't help feeling that the revolutionaries who had been doing everything for the people had now ended up being treated as the party's traitors and were detained, and I, as the child of the North, could do nothing to help. I still recall the instance in which I was trying to express my views concerning a comrade while on the phone with Son Sen, only to hear him threatening me at the other end of the line. He said, "Hey, Doi, that was Kun's confession. Kun was the revolutionary name of Khoi Thun." Later, during the course of conversation, I would hear him talking about the expression, "Keeping you is no gain, losing you is no loss." Mok's second son-in-law was appointed to Overseas Division 450 after the North people had been arrested.
Et lorsque les gens de Khoi Thun ont été arrêtés, ils ont été remplacés par des gens de Mok.
People from comport, for example,
par exemple,
were
des gens de
employed to work as secretary of Stone District, replacing Kampong Cham people. Mok San was given control of Kampong Chen commune, my village, replacing the former staff who were the children of the local villagers of Kampong Chen. Based on my analysis, I am convinced that the killing of people of other groups was meant to remove them by having them replaced by Mok's people. This is characteristic of the purge during that time. I believe that was the theory of the supercultural revolutionaries, destroying all humankind, creating a new one. The CPK regarded Mok and his people as the top people who could solve every problem. I would like to quote from Pol Pot's speech during the 17th of April 1978 anniversary as follows. Nothing can be more scientific than the peasants who are experienced in rice transplanting and the warriors who have known how to win a battle. I'd like to unearth the truth as follows. First, Kampot people who were assigned the post of the secretary of Stong district forced peasants to look for a kind of rattan to tie rice stacks. It was not very easy to find such rattan in my village. It was very inconvenient. Second, when I reported to Sun Sen that people were deprived of their food, he replied to me by phone right away that this could happen because enemies had not been all arrested. Later, I once again reported to him, based on the information I received from my mother, to the effect that the Southwest people had also deprived villagers of their food. This time, Sun Sen was silent. I believe that assigning cadres from other places as the secretaries of the cooperatives was proved to be a grave mistake. On the one hand, the party's line was criminal in nature already. On the other hand, it was even more destructive to have people from distant locations to break the local people. This led to more destruction in all fields, in particular the souls of more than 1 million vanished. According to my analysis and conclusion, people of every village experienced the same thing as what happened in my village. The purge was carried out further into the west zone after the zone or the central zone had been purged. First, they just wanted to request C to give them some people who could be the sources to arrest Op C. Such as the brother-in-law and the chief of the zone police, who could be the sources to the arrest of C. They maintained the notion that before you harvest the bamboo, you must trim off its thorns. Note, C was hungry to kill people, and so were Bok and Mok. However, C made them feel uncomfortable because he had an attempt to reshuffle Pal's force. Pal was the secretary of the West Zone. He was very trusted by Pol Pot and Nguyen Chia. C was arrested just after April 1978, the 17th of April. Mok was appointed as the secretary of the West Zone on top of his current rank. Pal remained the deputy secretary. The remaining of C's force was reshuffled. After C had been arrested, Nhiem Thu was arrested. Nhiem was arrested perhaps in May 1978. Nhiem was arrested when Mok was appointed to be the secretary of the Northwest Zone, an additional position onto of his current ones. Mok himself made it clear by saying that he wished to become the patriarch of as many pagodas as he could. Someone from the West Zone was made the deputy secretary, while its members were those from the Southwest Zone. The lower cadres from the communal level were purely the people from the Southwest and the West Zone.
de l'Ouest.
The purge was conducted at the E-Zone in June 1978. The purge of the E-Zone was carried out in an unprecedentedly large-scale fashion. Approximately 300 E-Zone combatants were sent to S21 and smashed without being interrogated. The cadres of the sectors, zones, military cadres were all sent to be smashed. Interrogation was no longer needed. As for Sao Pum, who did not expect that Pol Pot would make a decision to smash him, asked somebody to comply or to accompany to see Pol Pot. I heard that when Pol Pot learned of the news that Sao Pum was committing or coming to see him, he ordered his force to arrest him. Finally, Sao Pum shot himself. 11 October 78, Gong Cha, alias Sai, was arrested and sent to S21, and on the 2nd of November 1978, Won Wei was arrested and sent to S21. As of the 2nd of November 1978, the organizational nature had changed in all sections. The Central Standing Committee changed, the members of the Central changed, the committees of zone, sector, district, sub-districts also changed, the committees of the ministry offices changed, the Central Army changed. The Standing Committee's meeting that appointed the General Assembly of 1976, which included the servant people, Pol Pot, the secretary, Nguyen Chia, the first secretary, Sao Pum, the second deputy secretary, Ong Chuen, alias Mok, the fourth deputy secretary, Yeng Sari, the full-fledged standing committee member, Won Wei, the standing committee, or the candidate for member for the standing committee, Son Sen, also the candidate for the standing committee. In that General Assembly of 1978, the decision was made as follows. Pol Pot was appointed as the secretary, Nguyen Chia the first secretary, Ong Chuen the second deputy secretary, Yeng Sari. I have no idea whether he was promoted to the third secretary or the full tri, or still remained as the full tri member. Son Sen was, I don't know, promoted to the full tri member or still be the candidate member. Kyu Sampon was promoted to be the full tri member or the candidate member, but I'm not quite sure. The standing committee the office of the 870 changed significantly, including that of the industry, energy, etc. The committee of the zones, the sector, the district, the sub-district have completely changed into its root, including those at the Kampong Cham area, Prevang, Swairiang, Po Sat, and Battambang. The central military, so far as I remember, only Division 164 remained, Division 503 and Division 801. Even Division 703, appreciated fully by Pol Pot during the Standing Committee's meeting on the 9th of 1975, disappeared. The name of the division disappeared and the secretary was nowhere to be found. Regarding other divisions, for example, Division 3110, 450, 170, 290, was disarmed, and the combatants and cadres were used to work at the Kampong Chenang airfields, and later on they were arrested and smashed en masse before the 6th of January 1978. Cambodian people were arrested and were put to worked very hard.
And
there were
dur.
Only two classes, the peasant
classes,
and the worker classes. Pol Pot used these classes as official classes from the 6th of January 1978. The recollection of the event on the 20th of July 1962, Doucemont disappeared. End of February 1963, the General Assembly, the extraordinary one, rubber stamped Pol Pot as the secretary of the party, replacing Nguyen Chia. In 1968, Ma Mong died. Mok became the secretary of the Southwest Zone. In 1974, Pol Pot abandoned Cai Bo. I thought that it was the trick of Mok. In 1974 and 1985, Pol Pot, says the accused, did not allow Sun Sen to maintain his current position, and he thought that I thought that this was the trick of Mok again. In 1997, Pol Pot smashed Sun Sen and his whole family. This is the last event Pol Pot tried to order the execution of people. I believe that this was the conflict or the dispute between Pol Pot and Sun Sen. I think that during the meeting, Mok ordered the killing of Sarun San, and Mok declared the war in order to save his criminal regime.
63.
If we talk about Pol Pot, since Doucemont disappeared, he was the highest person. He really designed the theory and the line to destroy, to kill people heinously, and the 10 criteria for selecting cadre. If you look at this notion, it was flexible, humble, but in reality it was very cruel. It was a selfish policy. However, I believe that Pol Pot used a trick, a kind of trick used by Stalin when he killed Trotsky in order to kill Han Ngao and me and my wife. Luckily, I survived. Unfortunately, my wife died. Han Ngao was killed because he appeared in the film The Killing Field. And they wished to kill me and my wife in order to shut us up. Although these three people were not able to kill them, but they tried their best. 64. The details of the events, the recollecting events I wish to address before the court is to tell the court that the Khmer Rouge regime would like to use the killing as the mechanism to build their dynasty in Cambodia and to fulfill their
ambitions des Khmer Rouge.
I already made it clear before the chamber already that Pol Pot was a criminal person. Pol Pot really wanted to become a king, a so-called king, and he regarded Mok as his force who are supporting him both in the military and economically. Pol Pot wished to become the so-called king under his class, a revolutionary class policy in which he said the pure class
visait à ne garder que les classes pures.
From the 17th of April 1975 to the 6th of January 1979, Throughout the entirety of the 17th of April 1975 until the 6th of January 79, it was the period the CPK had the full control over the complete territory of Cambodia. First, the party tried its best to change the people into the collective peasants, the collective workers, and those who rejected or challenged such policy were ended up being smashed. Number two, within the party, the party purged and destroyed other forces and put their own forces
les autres forces et ne
to replace the positions.
Les forces susceptibles de maintenir
the people who had the full-fledged right, according to the essence of the document on the 30th of March 1976, were as follows.
Étaient les suivants.
Pol Pot,
Nguyen Chien,
Sao Pum,
Ong
Chuen
alias
Mok,
Von Vet,
Son Sen,
Kieu Sampan,
Khoi Tuon,
Manya,
Rus Nhâm,
Kai Pok,
Chu Chet
alias Si,
Kong Chap alias Sai. About the Santébal of the CPK, or the Democratic Cambodia, there were at least, I would like to repeat, there were at least Santébal offices, 196 offices.
One,
the general aspect of all Santébal offices. About the organizational mechanism. Each Santébal was under the clear supervision of the party. For example, the district Santébal offices were under the direct supervision of the secretary of the district. It was not under the supervision of the committee of the district. 71, the confession of from the Santébal office was the very confidential document, and it has to be given directly and in person to the superior. It was the superior who assigned someone or to pick up the document. Santébal offices at the rural area was under the supervision of the district secretary or under the supervision of the secretary of the sector or the zone. Any confession had to be sent through such organizational arrangement to Pol Pot. This is the principle which could not be violated. For example, on the 5th of September 07, I reported to the co-investigating judges already about the confession from Sector 32, D16.2, Document D58/2, which was the confession from the Santébal office of Sector 21 of the East, Document E52/4.62, Mok annotated in person on the cover of that confession to be sent to Pol Pot, D32/4 or D43/4, the accompanied letter sent to Sai Gong Cha, the secretary of the North Zone, or 801 U, sent the confession to Yip alias Kon and Sai alias Pang to Pol Pot. Note, these four documents reached Pol Pot so that Pol Pot could manage. Regarding S21, it was under the supervision of Son Sen. The confession Son Sen was interested would be he would be annotated on them and have them sent to Pol Pot to examine and make the final decision. For example, document E3/20, the confession of Heng Bích, alias Chan, D93/3, the confession of Long Mui, alias Jun. Note, E3/86, Son Sen annotated for the decision made by Nguyen Chia. So he sought decision from Nguyen Chia. At that time, Nguyen Chia was the minister, the acting minister, or in other words, he was the acting secretary of the party. The party valued the confession. S21 was under the supervision of Son Sen, who was the standing committee's member. Actually, Son Sen was the seventh individual, Sao Pum the third individual, Mok the fourth one.
All
Sandebal offices were equal before the party. Now look at document D32/4 or D43/4. The party was interested in particular in the size letter sent along on the 17th of April 1978. Nguyen Chia read it and on the 19th of April 1978. E3/416 was the document of S21 which was interested by Pol Pot very much. The confession that derived that was from from the Santibal office of Sector 32. The West Zone, Pol Pot was also interested in those confessions. That's why he asked or instructed Son Sen to advise S21. At that time, Nat was the chairman, and I was not. D16/2 was the reference document. The right to smash.
Le droit de liquider.
The Santibal office had no right to smash. To put it simply, the chief of the Santibal office, whoever he was, had no authority to issue any subjective order to arrest anyone. Document dated on the 30th of March 1976 was the nature and essence of such a policy. Who violated such measures of the party would be punished. For example, Nat, the secretary of S21 was a practical example. According to the meeting of the Standing Committee on the 19th of 20 and 21 of April 1976, they prohibited Nat to control any forces. Note, if we use the term arrest, in the eye of the history, it was to be done clearly by the order, and it was real. Santibal office had to wait to receive people who were arrested and sent to them. The people who were superior had to send the people to them to be interrogated and smashed at the end. Important people who were being interrogated and who were smashed accidentally were those who were responsible of the smash of those people would be considered to be violating the rule.
Now,
the torture, the physical torture during interrogation, physical torture was inevitable. It was the tactic allowed by the party. It was well known by the party. Document D43/4, which was dated on the 26th of October 1977, under ERN 00173923. zero. The interrogator indicated that he inflicted torture to extract this confession, to be sent to the central office, document number zero, in case file 002. D43/4, document dated 28 of October 77, and the page ERN 00174762. The interrogator indicated that torture was used, and the confessions were sent to the Northwest Zone, the case file 002. Therefore, torture or physical torture was employed at all Santé Bal office. Otherwise, the party would not inform the S21 to employ such techniques. The interrogator had the same privilege. During Sihanouk, Lolnol regime, the interrogation work was the work of the inspectors, the police inspector. In the Khmer Rouge regime, it was the work of the interrogator. When I was in jail, I was never saw any colonel or the person who ranked lower than the colonel came to visit me. The chief of the Santé Bal of Khmer Rouge, all together, including them and I, believed that no one would be maintaining the ruling position. The aspect of S21 is unique from other Santé Bal offices. Office S21 was unique because the member of the standing committee all were detained and interrogated and smashed here. And this is true. The other reason is that Pol Pot regarded these people as the thorns in his eyes, which have to be monitored, observed, and measures had to be taken. For example, Khoi Thun, 25th of January 77, Thun was sent to S21 on the 29th of January 1977. Thun completed his confession. On the 31st of January 1977, the purge of Thun's network was conducted, according to the implication in his confession. However, the more than 195 Santé Bal offices all across the country. I don't know whether any of the members of the standing committee was ever sent there and smashed. So this is true, I think. They were not sent there. Actually, according to my analysis, the Santé Bal office, all Santé Bal offices received order to smash people from the zone. And those people were the innocent, the clean, the very honest people, and there were more than 1 million of them who perished. I don't believe that the more than 1 million people who were killed had committed any wrongdoing as accused by the Central Committee members of the party, including Pol Pot. Having considered or having looked into this matter, I am still very terrified. So all the people of the zone, most of them have been sent to S21. They included the chief from Santé Bal offices. And it is true, because Pol Pot wanted to understand, to grasp the information of the zones. To put it simply, it was to monitor the secretaries of the zone whom Pol Pot did not trust. People who were sent from the zone, some were sent by Pol Pot through the confessions at S21,
ou par le truchement des aveux.
So from this power, I can conclude that when KW 30 was sent to M13 for a while, it was he was regarded as a semi-prisoner. I was interested that maybe at the rural level, the party would use this kind of policy to replicate the phenomenon happened at S24. I would like to recall some of the events of S21 crimes. On the 15th of August 1975, Son Sen presented and suggested the establishment of S21. On October 1975, I worked at S21 as the deputy chief. On the 3rd of 1976, I became the chairman of S21. From the 15th of August 1975 to October 1975, my core role was to collect evidence from the senior officials' houses and public buildings, those who were working for the Lonol regime, and to examine confessions sent from 703. Document E5/2.2 could be used as the reference. From the October 1975 to the 3rd of 76. When Nat was the chief, I was the deputy chief. There were two points I would like to clarify. He asked that I would go to the sector 25 to arrest some people. It was not part of my capacity or my role to arrest people, and Nat had no right to make such order or decision. But at M13, it was the same. No one allowed, or no, the party did not allow us to communicate with the base. According to the document, I can conclude that the party was interested in the crimes. The crimes on to the more than 12,380 people. I still am responsible, and I will forever be liable for the crimes. 86. Other aspects of the crimes at S21 and in Phnom Penh and at Prey Saw and Chiang Ai that have already been well debated in this chamber. The President, the accused, could you please slow down a little bit for the good record?
Pour que nous puissions avoir un compte rendu fidèle de ce que vous dites.
Ampi kol chumho nung akabriya rabak nyom. Mui thom chumpo parchi chun kampuchiya tu tiang parti.
About my position and behavior. One, for Cambodian people throughout the country. Before its victory day, the Communist Party of Cambodia had solemnly declared that it would only prosecute the seven super traitors. But in reality, the party forcibly evacuated the people, many hundreds of thousands of whom were executed. They were innocent. Those people did not commit any crimes after the 17th of April 1975. The killing went on. More and more people were put to death endlessly until more than 1 million souls perished. Among them, people who were outside the ranks, those who did not wish to become peasants or workers, sometimes simply because they were not able to do so, were executed. Within the ranks, party members who were associated with groups other than theirs were arrested and killed so that their people would be deployed to fill in the places. This monumental destruction, both within Outside the ranks is solely the crime committed by the Communist Party of Cambodia. I still honestly stand by the statement I made earlier in the hearing, in which I attested that Pol Pot was overjoyed and dared impose such an extremely criminal line due to the fact that he enjoyed the support of his force, especially the party's force, which I comprised 100,000 party members who I abided by his order. I still acknowledge that I was a member of the Pol Pot's force. Accordingly, I am psychologically accountable to the entire Cambodian population for the souls of those who perished during the period from the 17th of April 1975 until the 6th of January 1979. I am deeply remorseful of and profoundly affected by destruction on such a mind-boggling scale. I clearly understand that any theory or ideology which mentions love for the people in a class-based concept and class struggle is definitely driving us into endless tragedy and misery. I still maintain that a decision to choose which path to walk is made in a matter of seconds. However, its repercussion, if it is wrong choice, will result in a lifelong remorse. Instead of being convinced that I could be contributed to liberation of the nation and its people, and having hoped that I would be serving my people, I instead had devoted myself, my strength, my heart, my intelligence, and everything, including my preparedness, to sacrifice my own life for the nation and the people. I found I had ended up serving a criminal organization which destroys its own people in an outrageous fashion. I could not withdraw from it. I was just like a cog in a running machine for the victims of S21 and their families. I still claim that I am solely and individually liable for the loss of at least 12,380 lives. These people, before their deaths, had endured a great and prolonging suffering and countless inhumane conditions. I still and forever wish to most respectfully and humbly apologize to the dead souls. I have worshipped God to honor the dead. To the survivors, I stand by my acknowledgement of all crimes which were inflicted on you at S21. I acknowledge them both in the legal and moral context. As for the families of the victims, my wish is that I will always maintain my humble and respectful behavior by asking you to kindly leave your door open for me to make my apologies. May I plead with you to allow me to share your immense and enduring sorrow anytime in order to express my most excruciating remorse. I have fully and sincerely cooperated with the court anytime the court has needed me. I have been assisting the court for 10 years and 17 days, including during the investigation phase, as well as in the interrogation at the military court and at this court. Finally, I have made my genuine proposal to psychological and psychiatric experts to help me with the ideas on what I shall do to make people recognize me again as part of humankind, contribute to relieve the great sorrow of Cambodian people. I promise I will do everything for my people should they need me in whatever circumstance in the future. I pray the court to consider this additional matter. Mr. President, Your Honor, I have only read the entire text. In my text, there are footnotes. There are 34 footnotes that I may wish to read one by one.
Comme notre temps de bolé mouille.
Footnote number one.
Note de bas de page numéro un.
The forces and the military forces and the militias at the front lines. Two, the eight people were arrested by one way because he believed that there were no enemies. Three, Meng Samnang control sector 25. And Tang Kaek alias Khan conquered the southwest Santibal office or police office.
Le bureau de police du
Four, the supporting base people, he referred to the people who supported the revolution long before the 18th of March coup d'état. Five, the number of the people who died was not clear. Six, these people implicated in his confession, their confession. The reference is E2/2.5 and E2/2.29 for further information. Seven, before the coup d'état of the 18th of March 1970, Sarisai, the commander, and who was the district chief.
Chef de district.
Eight, before the coup d'état, this person lived on gambling.
De Paris.
This person's wife paid a visit to the person's house, and she was the infiltrator.
Nine.
This confession made the superior certify. However, I believe that the confession was true of only 50%. For example, the killing of the person by injection into the blood vein.
Méthode consistant à tuer par injection intraveineuse.
10.
Note 10.
The annex of D21,
annex au document
chapter 4, and, section 4 and section
4,
rather, section 5 and section 6. 11.
Note 11.
This person was not interrogated by me. He died before the 17th of April because of malnutrition. 12. Appendix. Annex D24, please read section 4, or rather section 6.4, ERN 00146679. 13, Annex D21, please read section 5 on the point about the Southwest, ERN 00146678.
14,
Annex D21, section 5, ERN 00146678. 15, D11/9. ERN 00146481 in Khmer.
En Khmer seulement.
16. In the written notebook of Mom Nai, ERN 00076681 through 00078056. I would like to repeat the ERN number. ERN 00076681 through 00078056. 17.
Not 17.
Some male alias man. He was the member of S21 who reported about his personal political life view through study session in 1975. 18, this confession or the speech was quoted from Campin, the secretary of 703. 20, I met Jane On at his wife's house in Tunle Smoot, Sector 15. Jane On was pleased and he promised on the 31st of May 1975 we would meet. On that day, he asked his messenger to ask me to tell me that the ANCA didn't agree or approve of my plea. 21, Nong Soon, alias Jay, the secretary, was removed by the party to now conquer the cash warehouse. Sokbot Chamrang and Huot Se were sent by Mok to the Nokobal or the police in the southwest.
22.
Nop Muen alias Rut was the secretary. Later on, Chai Kum Ho, alias Hock, was the secretary of energy.
23.
Dr. Rot Cook. The professor, Tut Mom, police inspector, Chut Yu, alias Chat, Song Hat, who were the base cadre, were
de la base
confused or was mistaken for Song Sat, the head of the former
chef
Phnom Penh Bank.
De
24. The standing committee of the zone, he referred to the secretary of the zone.
Secrétaire de la zone.
Yeah. Nguyen Chia was in charge. The East Zone was under the supervision of PUM. The Southwest, New Southwest, Mok, C, the West. After C was arrested on in April 1978, Mok became the secretary of the Southwest and the West. Northwest, Nyum.
Northwest, Yum.
North, New. Sai, after he was arrested on the 11th of October 78, Mok was the secretary of the Southwest, the West, and the Northwest, and the New North. 45, D45, page 5, the record of the interview of Kyu Sampon, 14th of December 2007, case file 002. The chief of the zone office,
le chef du bureau de zone,
who was the in-law of C, alias Soon, the person named Soon, I don't remember his full name. C, intention to reshuffle PAL force, made it clear that he intended to destroy the forces. C said in his final report that he did not wish to see that the net position was part of the working process. In the revolutionary flag, it was a reference to this point. 28. When Nhâm was arrested, Kong Sopal was, or alias Ke, was not yet arrested. I just received the information that the member of the Northwest zone
Nord-ouest
were armed to fight in the battle.
Pour aller au combat.
I only took note of this information. 29. Soknol, alias Lin, the chief of PM office, came to S21 on the 5th of June 1978. 30, according to the speech of Comrade Lin Islam, the committee of S71. 31, the statute of the party of 1976, article 21 and 22. 32, referring to my understanding, according to the interview with Ian Thierry by Steve Heder, page 54. 33, the name of the standing committee I have ever heard of were Kiu Sompon, Bok, Pal, Sarun, Sambut, Miesmut, Sumet, and Seung. The accused, Mr. President, I have already completed reading the document, but I would like to request for the submission of this document before the chamber or to the President. The President, the chamber now accepts the written remarks by the accused, which has already been made before the chamber, including the footnotes and attached documents.
Compris les notes de bas de page et les documents en annexe.
Mr. Parry, could you
please
go and fetch the documents and have them placed in the case file?
De bien vouloir prendre ce document en vue de le verser au dossier.
The President, since it is now an appropriate time to take a lunch adjournment, the Chamber will take the adjournment and resume the session at 1:30 p.m. The security personnel are now instructed to take the accused to the waiting room and return him to the courtroom by 1:30 p.m.
Veuillez vous lever.